Every 3 seconds, someone's in need of blood. I know that when I was able to get over my fears of donating blood, then I was able to donate blood and help people. Today, I hope to talk to you about why donating blood is important, the process of it, what you get out of it, and why you should be. So first, let's jump right on in to the need, what it is, and where does it go after you give that blood. So first, the donation process is just 4 simple steps. It's a medical background, a physical, the donation process, and then snacks. That simple. So the next thing is that all blood types are needed. And I know sometimes people say, "Oh no, you don't need my blood type." Yes, we do. We need every single blood type. So this is a chart of all the different blood types and the different blood that they can give. And as you can see, every single box up here and down here are checked in some way, shape, or form. So every single blood type is needed. And that is why you should be donating blood. So once we donate this blood, there's a question of where is it going and who are we helping? We're helping little boys like this. This is a little boy with cancer, and he's receiving blood transfusions. So the different people that are getting the help are cancer patients, trauma patients, sickle cell disease patients, burn patients, and patients with chronic disease. So when we're helping this little boy and many like him, it's making a big difference. Okay, so then there's some fun facts that I'm just going to read right off my page because I really, really don't want to mess them up. So 4.5 million people rely on blood transfusions. That's so many. But there are so many other people that could be giving those. So about 32,000 pints of blood are used every single day. And then if donors would just give 2 to 4 times a year, it would drop the blood need significantly. So just 2 to 4 times a year. That's all they ask. So now that you know why we donate and some fun facts about the donation process, you might ask, what's in it for you? What are you getting out of this process? Well, first, you're helping 3 people. For every pint of blood that you give, it can go to roughly 3 different people. And if that's not enough to drive you to keep coming back, which for most people it is, but there's some also great stuff as well. So there are also fun giveaways. They do different giveaways. You can be entered in to win fun stuff like Amazon Echo, Starbucks gift cards, regular gift cards, Visa gift cards, food. I've got a pie up here, but you know, any type of food, and AirPods. So also, when you're donating blood, you're going to learn about your blood type. And that blood type, you're able to know who you can give blood to and then what blood you can receive. So if there's ever a medical problem that you're going to need blood, you know it and you're able to tell medical personnel that before they need to look into it. It's just a quicker process. So then, did I also mention free food? At the end, you also get free food for donating. So that's awesome as well. So now that you know what's in it for you get fun giveaways, free food, just the satisfaction of knowing that your blood is going to 3 different people. But I'm sure there's a couple of you thinking, oh, I don't have the time. Oh, I don't have the health. Or maybe you're scared of needles. These are all very reasonable things to be thinking about. So for health, Red Cross came out and said that you only have to be 110 pounds and 16 years old. Those are really the only 2 requirements, and that you feel healthy, and then the day of that you feel healthy as well. So even diabetes patients can give as long as they are feeling healthy the day of. So this is super important. And so if you're feeling like, oh no, I'm not healthy enough, you are. And if you feel that you're not, then feel free to call and ask and talk to them about maybe those medical problems, and they'll be able to walk you through it. And never be afraid to ask. So the next thing is scared of needles. Red Cross also came out with 3 different tips to get over those concerns. So take pride in your donation. When you're taking pride in your donation, then you'll be more willing to give. To know the process, if you know what's going on and knowing that process, then you'll be able to calm down and relax, and because you know what's going on. And lastly, just relax. They say you could bring a book, maybe listen to some music, or even have a staff member talk to you. So these are all super important. And lastly, for time, it's just important to make the time. Maybe look at your schedule. It's the whole process takes 45 minutes, and 10 of those minutes are the actual donation process. So it might be even less than 45 minutes, but they say to give that 45-minute range. So maybe look to see when you have an open lunch period or something where you can just break away for 45 minutes or so to do that. And then also, some also take walk-ins. So even if you have just a couple minutes, and you realize, oh, I've got some time to kill, go donate blood. You know, maybe they'll take that walk-in. So now that you know about how to get over your fear, maybe you've got time issues, now you know how to get over those. Now you can donate blood. So what I want you to do today is look up just the nearest donation center to you. And maybe look how it works. Maybe the times they're open. Do you have to sign up online? Do you have to call? Do they take walk-ins? And just get some information about it. And make it fun. Go make it a date night. Make it with friends before you go out to dinner. Go all donate blood. Make it fun. Don't have it be this daunting task that you have to do. When you make it fun, then you're going to want to keep going back, and you'll get so much out of it. So I know that when you donate blood and you get over that fear, you'll have a rewarding experience, and you'll be able to close the scare of the 3 seconds that every time someone needs blood. Thank you.